I know I need to come from behind.
It's what we call the toss-up ball right there.
This lake has the potential to do it.
Day one, Bassmaster Classic, first 5 minutes.
There are 25-pound sacks weighed in here often.
Yeah!
That's choking it right there.
19 pounds, 10 ounces!
Perfection is the moment where preparation meets opportunity. I've got 8 hours to make it happen.
It's the final day of the Bassmaster Classic. I'm here, I'm gonna go out and do what I can do.
Cliff a pace, it sets a pace.
You know, there is no defense in the sport. For us, it's gonna be all just about what we can do and we can control.
Yeah!
If Cliff has a bad day and I have a great day, we make magic happen.
The 2013 Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa.
Well, this is it. There is nothing like it in the world of sports. The final day of the World Championship of Fishing, the Bassmaster Classic, 2013 edition, Grand Lake of the Cherokees. And here in Tulsa, Oklahoma, they are excited about it. Everyone is excited about it because the winner, the one who takes home that trophy, will get an immediate kick in the terms of $500,000. His name in the history books, written big time, and of course, a life change. Your life gets a lot easier if you win the Bassmaster Classic. I'm Tommy Sanders, along with Mark Zona. So many stories over the 3 days of fishing. As we go into this final day, there is one story about one angler who has a substantial lead.
Really, that's the only story right now. If you look at our leader, Cliff Pace, 7-pound lead, and this angler has never won a Bassmaster Elite Series event before, more or less a Bassmaster Classic. Really, if you're to equate a 7-pound lead, that's like having a 3-touchdown lead going into the fourth quarter. We're looking for two things on this final day. Either he's going to blow this thing away in the first 2 hours, or an epic collapse, one of the two right now.
It's hard to pick what's gonna happen, but we do know this. This final day is unlike any other these guys ever faced. So many different things you have to deal with.
Well, the one thing he's gonna deal with today, number one, Grand Lake has got him. Grand Lake loaded with big bass, and we've seen huge stringers all week long. But the other thing is the extra attention that's gonna be on Cliff Pace, whether it's spectator boats, helicopters, the weight of the bass fishing world will be squarely on his shoulders.
Cliff Pace, a 7-pound lead, he's getting ready to go. He is with our own Robbie Floyd right now.
Cliff, you've been in this situation before, the Bassmaster Classic with a chance at victory. You come up a little short that year at Hartwell. What's gonna be the difference this year?
Well, I hope I don't come up a little bit short. I'm just gonna go out there today and take it for what it is and just keep it just fishing.
Not only is he fishing for $500,000, but also that Bassmaster Classic title. What's the pressure like at takeoff this final day?
The pressure's pretty big today. You know, it's really good. I've accomplished it in the last 2 days, but today's the day that counts. I think today, you know, a guy's going to have to just catch a good stringer of fish. I put myself in contention doing what I'm doing. We're just going to go do it again and hope for the best.
How scared are you about the weather? It's a lot warmer than it's been all week, and it's supposed to be 60 today.
Yeah, I'm just going to fish the weather, you know. You gotta fish the moment in these deals. You gotta fish the conditions you currently have. That's something I learned a long time ago, and that's what I'm gonna do today throughout the day.
Cliff Pace, the day three leader. He hopes that he's 8 hours away from a Bassmaster Classic victory.
We are finally underway on this final day of the Classic. Our Skeeter rules of the game. 8 hours of fishing on this final day. 25 anglers left in it at this point. Your 3-day total is what can win you the Bassmaster Classic, the title of world champion, and the trophy.
Follow Cliff Pace right now, starting where he has started every day of the tournament. And really what is surrounding Cliff Pace right now is everything that he is not. Cameraman, helicopter, spectator boats. Cliff Pace, he said the only thing those things do is get in his way. In fact, a statement he made, he said anything that gets between him and a bass is purely a hindrance. And the other thing where we said possibly an epic collapse, he is high risk, high reward. Cliff Pace is not getting a lot of bites. On day number two of the tournament, 7 keeper bass.
All right, for all of that and not knowing what's gonna happen to him today, we have to say he has been masterful the first 2 days of this Bassmaster Classic. 21 pounds and 12 ounces on day number two. Day number one before that, 21 pounds and 8 ounces. He begins this, the final day of the Classic, with a full 7-pound lead over his nearest competitor.
How long a record before he runs out of gas? The helicopter.
Oh, that helicopter is just one of the distractions he's going to have to deal with, as does anyone who has the lead the final day of the Bassmaster Classic have to deal with. It is not an easy day to navigate your way through, but Cliff Pace has got to find a way if he's going to hang on to that lead and bring it home.
Get in here, boy.
Yes!
Four more times. Y'all help me out. I know y'all here and y'all want to see it get done, but if we're going to see it get done, I'm going to have y'all's help.
The help that Cliff Pace is asking for is for them to back off a little bit. They got to back off enough to where he feels confident that his fish are not being disturbed. So this is an important part. Crowd control, and you can be successful at it or you can be unsuccessful at it. It generally gets better year after year. Crowds are pretty understanding of these anglers.
In the Classic, though, you can multiply it by about 10 times from a regular Bassmaster Elite Series event.
Going to move now from Cliff Pace over to a young man who came in a bit under everyone's radar. Hank Cherry of North Carolina qualified for the Bassmaster Classic through the Bass Pro Shops Open, Southern Open Division. Did a great job, won a tournament on Smith Mountain Lake, and here he is, and he's doing well.
And really, Hank Cherry did not want a slugfest. You look at him earlier this morning with his son Christian. It's a great shot right there. But Hank Cherry said, "I am used to wintertime tournaments. I wanted this to be brutally cold." The reason why, he said, it fills other anglers' heads with negativity. I knew this one would be a grind.
Come on, 5-pounder early. Put some fear into them. Come on, five. Fours and fives. You live here. There's one of them right there. A big one, buddy. That is a toad if it's a bass. That's a bass. It's a damn monster. Oh, it's a bass, too. It's a big one. Look at all of them down there with it. School. Oh, stay there. Get your big butt over here. Get your big butt over here. Get your big butt over here. No, you don't. No, you don't. There you go, Mr. Christian. That's for you, son. Woo! That is what you call choking it. Look at that. That's getting it. I'm about to pee in my pants. Son, 4-pounders. Oh, how am I at? Give me some. God, they ain't been here the whole time. Finally. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Oh. Four more of them and old Clifford's gotta catch them. Oh yes, thank you, Jesus.
Hank Cherry summed it up pretty good right there. He's gonna need four more that big, maybe even bigger, because Hank Cherry is starting this final day almost 12 full pounds behind the leader, Cliff Pace. Cliff Pace trying to bring it home, starting with a 7-pound lead over his nearest competitor, final day of the Bassmaster Classic.
Really, if you want to know about the Bassmaster Classic, the history of the biggest event in bass fishing, well, Tommy Sanders, there's really only one way to find out.
Yeah.
It's by the numbers.
Pro anglers don't get to look at scoreboards on the water. They don't know how well their opponents have done until they reach the weigh-in stage.
E squared is leading!
They have to consider all the factors and base their game plan on probability. Will my pattern or spot have enough fish to outlast everyone? Bass fishing is truly a numbers game. .556. That's the total number of anglers to fish the Classic. Only 33 have captured the trophy. That means just 6% of entrants have ever claimed the big prize.
Person is your winner!
Gary Klein has the most Classics without a win at 29, while Tommy Biffle owns the current streak at 18. 5 men have won multiple Classics, led by Kevin Van Dam and Rick Klun with 4 Classics each.
Kevin Van Dam shuts the door at number 4!
Van Dam's 3-day weight of 69 pounds, 11 ounces on the Louisiana Delta is the heaviest ever tallied in the modern era of the 5-fish limit. But Klun still holds the all-time record of 75.8 in 1984, when the limit was 7 fish a day. Surprisingly, only one angler has ever beat the curse of the local, won the Classic in their home state. That was Boy Duckett in Birmingham, Alabama in 2007.
Duckett in the record books, Bassmaster Classic champion!
Next year, we return to Birmingham for Alabama's 12th Classic, the most of any state. But these 53 men are focused on Tulsa, and the chance to alter their lives forever. They're all wondering who's gonna become number one.
The Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa, is brought to you by Minn Kota, Toyota, Triton Boats, and by Skeeter Boats.
Things are happening. Things are popping on the Grand Lake of the Cherokees here in northeastern Oklahoma. Final day of the Bassmaster Classic, and the fishing is underway. We started with 53 anglers. We're down to 25. 25 only have a shot at winning the World Championship title this time. And on this day, you don't leave anything on the table. It's the time to be aggressive. You have to hit a knockout punch because winning the Classic is everything. Let's get out to Michael Iaconelli.
Track Mike Iaconelli right now and look at where he's starting. He started here every day of this event, and on day number 2, Tommy Sanders, fair to say, up and down morning, a lot of mechanical issues, not the case today. And every day of this event, Michael Iaconelli said there is a window, the first hour and a half, absolutely critical.
Yeah, it was the deal. I had to go a little deeper bait. That's the first one I had to measure all week. And that's not a keep. It's a sign, though, maybe. Yeah, fish definitely came a little deeper. So that might have been a good change for us. We'll see here. That's the thing with these fish. You got another one. Yep, that was the deal. That's a big one. That's a big one. That's a big one. That's a giant. Oh God. Oh God. Hang on. That's the kind we need right here. Yeah! 4-pounder. And that's the kind of fish that'll win you the Bassmaster Classic.
What a great early result for Michael Iaconelli. He'll need that and more as he begins 8 pounds plus behind our leader, Cliff Pace, on this final day of the Classic. But Iaconelli already ahead of his schedule yesterday, where he had all sorts of difficulties and missed an important window of opportunity. Let's back off from Iaconelli, head out to one of the pre-tournament favorites for sure. That's Oklahoma's Jason Christie.
Possibly one of the biggest favorites in Bassmaster Classic history. Really, Christie, more knowledge on this lake than any competitor in the field. And he has dug himself a big hole, a subpar day two. Jason Christie will need all of that local knowledge to dig himself out of the hole he's created.
I'm telling you, they were going to catch him. I just got that crazy psycho feeling that it's going to happen. Here he is. Bam.
That right there is the scary thing for our leader, Cliff Pace. All of these anglers that really, really behind, they all said, have to go for a big bag today. Jason Christie with a monster Grand Lake bass.
Yeah, Christie said, I'm definitely going to freewheel it today. The old game plan is out. Let's go further down the Grand Lake of the Cherokees, catch up with the number one man in bass fishing, Kevin Van Dam, who was so enthusiastic about his chances before this tournament began. But a great day one, 19 pounds plus, followed by a difficult day two, about 11 pounds. He's in a hole. He's got to dig himself out of it today.
I got a pretty good pattern on this end of the lake. It's just if we can have enough of it with this wind blowing on it to be able to execute all day long. I found it in practice, you know, this stretch of just these short little main lake pockets, and the big ones were in them. I caught a really big bag. Exact same conditions as we have today, so to see how much pressure's on it to make it happen. There he is, big one. Big one. I caught a great big one right there in practice, too. Yep, giant. I mean, kind you need five of. Look at that cow. That's the ones right there. 6 pounder.
Four more.
Yeah. That might be the same one I caught in practice. It looks about like it.
A more familiar situation with Kevin Van Dam right there, really knocking it out of the park early here. If he'd just not had that one bad day, he'd be in a completely different situation right now as it stands. Even with that fish, he's 10 pounds behind our leader, Cliff Pace, who's off to a decent start, and of course started with a fantastic lead. So for all these anglers giving chase, they're going to have two things happen. Cliff Pace has got to run into a bit of trouble, and they're going to have to find some way to catch him better than they did on day two.
In theory, the wind will make the reaction bite better. You know, the jerk baits, the crank baits. If it happens, it happens. It's possible.
The wind's gonna blow. They're not gonna be able to drag their little baits around and catch them the way they're catching them. And Cliff can say what he wants, but I know that's what he's doing. He's not gonna be able to do that. It's gonna be a different story.
This is it, the day of reckoning, the final day of 3 days of competition in the Bassmaster Classic 2013. 25 anglers on the water. Got to make something dramatic happen today. They're all chasing angler Cliff Pace. Let's see what's going on. Our leader, Cliff Pace, started his day with a 7-pound lead. Had a little success earlier. After that, it sort of tapered off for him.
Oh, God, come on.
Starting to see Cliff Pace struggling a little bit from him over to Kevin Van Dam. Guys, starting to mount a little bit of a charge early here. See Kevin Van Dam with a keeper right there, but he already has one good one in the live well.
That's a bite.
Kevin Van Dam soldiering on, a 10-pound deficit for him at this point, falling behind Cliff Pace. How about our Bass Nation angler who's done the best in this tournament? Jonathan Carter, first ever Bassmaster Classic qualifier from the state of Maine. He is not going to go away. This guy came to play, and that's exactly what he's doing.
Over to Shaw Grigsby, fishing just off of the main lake, and really Shaw Grigsby quietly having a solid classic.
That's not good right there. I don't know what I just got into, but I got into it. All right, here's my next fish. Either that or I'll be hung, because that's a heck of a dock right here. Golly, it's gonna be a good one. Golly, look at this. Yeah, baby. Take number two right there. Yeah.
Shaw Grigsby, so strong for so many years, and he may be the senior member of this crew that's contending for the title on the final day, but he is a man to be reckoned with.
Take a look at where Hank Cherry's fishing right now, and he really fished this entire event right next to Van Dam outside in the mouth of Honey Creek. Hank Cherry, really no pressure on him today. With the lead Pace has, Hank Cherry knows this one is not out of reach.
It's the final day of the Bassmaster Classic. I made it this far. I don't think there's anyone that was really betting or counting on me to get here. I'm here. I'm going to go out and do what I can do. I mean, I really think from practice and kind of what I think I figured out this afternoon, I think I can catch 20, 25-pound bag again, no problem.
Come on, it's going to happen. Oh, be a bass. That's a damn big one. Please, God, be a bass. My heart's beating like 90 miles an hour. I think I got one stupid drum. But it ran pretty hard. Oh, it's a bass, it's a bass, it's a bass! Go. Come on. Please, baby, stay there. Come on, get up here, get up here. Boom! Thank you, Jesus. Give me some. Put the camera down. Let's go.
Hank Cherry, the Open Division qualifier from North Carolina. With that fish, he vaults all the way from sixth right into second place. Cliff Pace still has his 7-pound lead, but he's got a different face running him down from behind.
Exactly right, Tommy Sanders. Cliff Pace said, I am not getting a ton of bites. I'm catching quality, but his only worry has to be not getting a number of keepers.
It's game time now. We just need a couple more bites today to close this thing out today. I think now's the time that you got the best chance to get them. So I'm gonna go fish some stretches that I've had some big bites on. I'm not getting many bites in those areas, but I'm gonna go spend the rest of my afternoon just looking for those one or two key bites, and hopefully we'll get them. Everything's perfect. Water's warmed up, wind's blowing right in on it. I mean, couldn't ask for it to be any better. Why can't I not get a bite on this stuff?
Cliff Pace has controlled this classic since day one, very specific spots on Grand Lake.
Exactly, and if you really look right there, that's a perfect look at it. Creeks and guts off of the main lake. And he said the number one key, it's just 1 degree warmer than out on the main river. But right now, very slow going for Cliff Pace.
I'd sure like to catch some more. It's just, it's hard to get a bite. It's been like this all week. First day was the best, you know, the best day I've had as far as number of bites. God. Oh my gosh. Hey guys, man, I'm gonna fish all that right there.
Starting to ratchet up a little bit.
You heard Cliff Pace earlier. If I can get a couple more good fish in the boat, I can put away this classic, but he's got to deal with a lot more than just that. He's got to direct traffic, and that is part and parcel of being the leader on the final day.
He has to deal with the zoo out there. Over to Brandon Polinick, who's had a very, very quiet and consistent classic. Brandon Polinick fishing in the mouth of Echo Bay. Tommy Sanders, he has had this area to himself the entire event.
Brandon Polinick, of course, a big splash when he first came out here, fished his first classic, made the top five, fishing toe-to-toe with Kevin Van Dam, Aaron Martins, and the others on the final day of that Louisiana Delta Classic. He's been there. He's got the experience. Maybe his time to really make it pay off.
What we've got is the main river channels right out in front of us. And we've got kind of a creek channel swing that swings up close to this bank before it runs back in onto this big spawning flat. And this is really kind of the last little steep drop before it rolls up on the big spawning flat here, you know, close to the main channel. And these fish are just kind of staged up here. It's shallow, it's only 3 to 6 foot of water. A little bit dirtier water, but they're staged up here. We got a bunch of kind of mix. There's kind of a rock vein that runs out there right on the little drop from 3 to 6. And it's kind of got a few scattered brush piles on it out there. Oh,
got one.
Can't tell how big he is yet. Don't jump, don't. Oh, that's a good one. It's a good start.
Come here.
Got her.
Woo!
We got a start. It's a solid 2.5 pounder. On the board. It's official. Now we only got a 5 pound deficit. Yeah, we got a start. You know, that gives me a lot of confidence that, you know, the areas I'm fishing are reloading. You know, I felt like they would, but that just confirms it. You know, I've caught fish here the first day, I caught fish here the second day, you know, and fished them fairly hard. So it's good to see, you know, more fish coming into the areas. It gives me a lot of hope for the rest of the day.
Left alone and his spot is reloading. That kid is a stud.
Second youngest angler in the field at this Bassmaster Classic, collected his first Bassmaster Elite Series victory during the past year. And again, he's got great classic experience as well. And Brandon Polinick moving up into a virtual tie for second place. Final day of the Bassmaster Classic 2013. This is it, the World Championship of Fishing. $500,000 to the winner, a place in history, and a life that has changed. It's all on the line, the number one day of the year in bass fishing. It's getting all too real for these guys out there today. Hey, we got the real deal with us right now, Sanders and Zona, and the G-Man. Hey, one of the biggest names in the sport. Got himself a Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year title. Just missed it by less than a fish being out there fishing today. But what are you figures going on right now?
I figure there's a lot of guys nervous on that ride back. This is a life-changing event. I think that the guys in the front know that. And I'm telling you, it's been a long day for them.
One of the things, we follow you all year long, one of the most popular anglers on tour. But the Classic is a different monster with different obstacles out there. Talk about what these guys run into out there.
Man, you get a lot of coverage, you get a lot of chase boats, you got a lot of people around you. So mentally, if you're not careful, it can take a toll. It's a little different than any other season. If it's a regular season, not quite this bad. With the Classic, they come out, they want to see it go down. They're here in force.
Having a big crowd at the takeoff is one thing. Having huge crowds at weigh-ins is another thing. But all those boats out there, when you're trying to fish, that makes, can make, has the potential to make specific things go wrong.
It can make you make bad decisions, guys. It can make you think too far out in advance of what you need to do. You're trying not to wash an area out before you get to it. So you really start trying to alter your game plan, and sometimes it can take you out of it.
All right, Mike Iaconelli's one of those guys that's dealing with it today.
I got to fish hard. The hardest thing is honestly is the fans. The fans are great, and I love the fans, and I love the spectators. But the boats today made it a real challenge to move around, to get around, and to fish areas effectively. You know, so you know, 10, 20 boats is okay. 30, 40, that's all right. But when you've got 80, 90 boats on you, and some are like yachts and cruisers, and they're blasting music, and they have diesel engines. That stuff negatively affects the environment. I'm not a biologist, but I can tell you that hurts. So, you know, I mean, tomorrow I have to really consider how I fish areas in conjunction with that big fan base.
Gee, you can prepare for almost any aspect of a tournament except that aspect. Having to do crowd control out there, manage that situation, it's just something you got to play by ear and hope for the best, right?
You really got to kind of put a game plan on it, guys. You can't just run in the back of a pocket and fish where you want to. When 90 boats behind you, you have to strategically stop and idle in. What normally takes you 7 to 10 minutes to fish a spot, now it's taking you 15, 20 minutes, even 25.
Looking at some of our leaders, you look at Iaconelli, you look at Hank Cherry, Cliff Pate. Who do you look at that can handle this mentally?
There's a couple of guys that can handle it. I think all the guys are up for it. I look at a guy like Hank Cherry that may be to an advantage. He's won a Southern Open. He's an excellent fisherman. First-time Classic qualifier, he may not have as many people. He's got freedom to make adjustments and react very quick to what's going on.
G-Man, thank you so much. I know you're a busy man today, sneaking over here doing this with us. Stay with us. We'll hang around. We'll all watch the weigh-in, which is coming sooner than you think for these guys out on the water.
It's a two-way street. You know, you got supporters, and, you know, you catch that fish, and they all hoop and holler and get fired up.
Stop!
But then those, you know, 2 hours go by and you don't get a bite, and you can feel 100 sets of eyes behind you watching, you know, the pressure gains. I mean, you get it going and you feed off of it, but when you lose it, you know, it doubles the pressure.
You're watching our coverage of the 2013 Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tulsa. And this is the way the sport starts its season. We're starting here on the Grand Lake of the Cherokees, and as we take a look at our Yamaha lay of the lake, it's about 45,000 acres of water, 1,200 miles. Shoreline, the water temperature on this day, chilly, 37 to 40 degrees, as we watch local favorite Jason Christie pick up and make a short run. The traffic following, and that's one of the elements that you absolutely have to deal with on an event the stature of the Classic, crowd management on the final day.
Well, the main thing with Jason Christie, Tommy, what he said was he's had a ton of attention in this tournament, and really most of the pressure he has laid on himself in this event. On day number one of the tournament, he said he could not even turn around and look at all the spectators that were on him.
That's right.
I'm a little more used to it here on day number three. Jason Christie has been fishing 30 to 40 spots each day of this event. He's really never bunkered into one area.
The angler from Oklahoma, the master of Grand Lake, had a specific game plan for this, but he says on this final day, look, I haven't got what I want yet. I'm going to throw it all out. I'm fishing by instinct on this day. I'll burn a tank of gas, hit all the spots I can think of.
Exactly, and on day number one, it was an up and down day for Christie, and he was vocal that he lost a big one, and that fish haunted him for the majority of the afternoon.
Jason Christie has not lost touch with the leaders, but he has not taken the lead at any point during this tournament. He'd like to do that today.
Hold on. Wyatt, when I gotta hurry and get another one.
Jason Christie moving fast. He'll have to get rid of that one at some point during the day to erase the huge deficit he's working against. Back to Michael Iaconelli. Look at what he's dealing with on this day.
And really one of the only anglers in the field that is bunkered into one area the entire event.
Pardon me. Is there a club tournament going on this week? Nobody knows how dry I am. Oh, God. Lay on there. My God, that sucker! Yeah! Yeah.
Uh-oh, unruly fan out there.
Michael Iaconelli working as hard as he can. All of these guys doing everything they can think of trying to run down the man who has controlled the narrative this week.
These fish will move a great deal in the course of, you know, in the course of 8 hours. Early in the morning, those fish have slid out, and they're getting a little deeper. You know, these fish are hard to judge unless you catch them on a regular basis.
I felt sure I could come here and catch some.
You just can't rush it, man. You just gotta let it happen. The worst thing a person can do in this deal is get in a hurry. Thank you, Lord. Not a big one, bigger than the one we ain't got.
Slow, painful grind for Cliff Pace.
Cliff Pace now with only two fish on this final day. First 2 days of the Classic, he did not fail to catch a limit, one of the pursuers, in fact, the guy who started the day. In second place, the young man, 25 years old from Idaho. Brandon Polinick really has had a stellar career for such a young guy in this business. Started out fishing the Bassmaster Classic as a representative of the Bass Nation, wound up in the top five at the Classic in New Orleans on the Louisiana Delta 2011. Came back, second Classic not so well, but his season last year on the Bassmaster Elite Series netted him a win. It's so hard to win out there on the Bassmaster Elite Series. This guy's proven in so many ways he's got what it takes.
Exactly, and one of the things that makes Brandon special, if you look at what he did last year, his victory at Bull Shoals, second place up in Green Bay, he gets away from the norm. In fact, the best way to describe it, he looks for things that other anglers miss.
This is Classic number 3. In my mind, I've won about 300,000 of them. You wouldn't believe at this level of competition how mental it is. So you have to envision yourself winning. When you do that, it gets your focus, it gets your drive going, and it makes a big difference. You know, you have to believe that you can win at any given moment.
There we go.
Oh, stay down. Oh, good one. Good, oh, it's a giant. It is a giant. Oh my gosh. Come on, baby. Barely hooked. Come here. Woo! Yeah! Yeah! Woo! Oh man, I needed that. They're still here. I had that fish barely hooked. I mean, one hook in that fish. That was fun. Let's do it again. I thought it was bigger than that when it first jumped.
Hey, next time, do us a favor and land it on this side, will you?
You know what? I was waiting for him to swim to that side. I'd really tried to get him to go there, but he wouldn't do it. There's one. Come on, come on. Easy now. Don't do that. Oh yeah. Another good one.
Yeah! That one's even bigger!
I mean, come on! I mean, let's make something happen here. That might have been a cluster this morning, but man, yeah.
Well, you know, this has got to be it. Our Evan Williams Bourbon Shot of the Day, Brandon Polinick, and a key fish. The angler from Idaho, making this thing close. How about Brandon Polinick and all that momentum? A lot more to come. Our coverage of the 2013 Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tulsa.
The Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tulsa, is brought to you by Nitro, Yamaha, and by Berkeley Tri-Lee.
You're watching the final day of the Bassmaster Classic 2013, the World Championship of Fishing, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tulsa. What a host city. Tulsa, Oklahoma has been capacity crowds every day, having fun in the BOK Arena. And as a matter of fact, Mark Zona, they had a little stunt the other day, kind of a thing to get everybody involved in it, and it's called the Harlem Shake.
Well, exactly right, Tommy Sanders. What we tried to do, and get ready for this, in the BOK Arena, we tried to accomplish the unofficial biggest Harlem Shake ever in the history of man.
Exactly so, and you can have a look at the results, well, right here. Watch what happens. Yeah, the music comes on, and everyone's pretty much on board with it. Got a good participation in the crowd. There's a matter of fact, go to YouTube, take a look at this, see if you think it's the biggest
ever Harlem in Shake the history ever. Of man.
In the history of man. How about that? Tulsa, Oklahoma. Getting on board with the Bassmasters in a big way, and we've got a fantastic classic going on. Hank Cherry, one of the guys who has excelled here, the North Carolina angler, one of only three people to break 20 pounds during the course of this event. Currently, Hank Cherry is 9 pounds, though, behind our leader.
He found him. Oh, I got him. He was coming to me. Oh, God!
So tough on the final day of the Classic, and I know you got to shake it off, but man, that's what really, part of what sunk his ship yesterday.
Exactly. You look at that giant right there, and on day number two, Hank Cherry missed a lot of bites, and a lot of people said, well, you know, those could have been small fish. That's not really the case. Hank Cherry has not been getting a lot of bites a day, and what he has caught have been really, really good fish. You kind of look at this footage, and you start to think, what might have been?
Yeah, what we don't realize when we watch this footage is that we're not seeing the long periods in between. Brandon Polinick, Cliff Pace both said we had 7 bites on day number two.
Please be good. Please be good.
Woo! Come on, get in here. Get in here, baby. Come on. Damn monster, son.
Come on. Please, baby. Please. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. You believe in this?
Oh. Wow, Hank Cherry loses a big one it up with an absolute giant.
Big, big doings right there. That effort brings him within 5 pounds of our leader, Cliff Pace. Holonick in second place, and here in fourth place is Mike Iaconelli. You remember his story from day number two. All sorts of troubles on an up and down day.
You dog!
Extremely frustrating day with equipment issues on day number two. And here on day number three, Michael Iaconelli going to go back to the exact same area where he had all that frustration earlier.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to yell at you yesterday. I was frustrated. My trolling motor was broken.
Woof. Very mature move by Michael Iaconelli right there. And I have to say it, Tommy Sanders, I'm not very sure that the apology was truly accepted by the dog.
Oh, got a little bit of wind coming. That could be good. There's a good one. There's a big one. There's a big one. It's a big one. God, it's a big one. It's a big one. How'd you come over there? Yeah! It's a good one. This is 3 pounder. Oh, look at a gut on that thing. He's round.
Iaconelli getting right there in the mix with Polinick and Cherry. The guy's trying to run down Cliff Pace, but it's Brandon Polinick still in second place as we speak right now. And you say he has done well by putting something different between him and the rest of the field.
Well, if you look at all the anglers in the top 10 throughout this classic, fishing typical wintertime deals, very, very steep banks. Brandon Polinick fishing very flat areas, areas where, well, number one, there is not a lot of other anglers getting out of the norm, and Brandon Polinick is feeling it on day three.
I am pumped up right now. You know, I've got two good ones in the box, and one more decent one. But to have three fish in the first hour, I mean, I'm right on par with what I had yesterday. About the same size-wise, too. So if I can just slowly keep culling up, you know, like I said earlier, I'm 5 bites a day. You know, that's all I'm looking for, and we got 60% of that right now. So, you know, if we can just get two more bites, and then, you know, we'll start looking to make some moves and gain some ground. Well, if Cliff hasn't caught one yet, I'd say we took the lead. But I'm sure he's probably caught one. There we go. Popped it off a rock. Oh. Come here, sucker.
Yeah! Hook just fell out.
Number four.
Number four.
Hey now, hey now. We're making something happen. Man, this is fun. And that was just a 2 pounder. Imagine what a 6 or 7 pounder would do to me. Right now, I have switched up and I'm catching them on a storm wigglewort right there. Little green ghost phantom craw. And that is how I'm catching these bad boys. I mean, it's almost like offshore fishing. You know, it comes off that little ledge, hits a few rocks, and they eat it. I mean, I felt that one roll over a rock and it just loaded up. And that's been the deal.
And I mean, it's pretty specific. It's a real sweet spot.
I can tell.
Brandon Polinick started this day 7 pounds behind the leader, Cliff Pace. And guess what? Unofficially, we've got Brandon Polinick a half a pound ahead of Cliff Pace. Pace has 2 fish in the boat. Brandon Polinick, you just heard him, he's got 4 fish right there. If he can keep on that track, we have got a ball game, an unexpectedly tight race on the final day of the Bassmaster Classic.
To be leading the Classic at 25, I don't know.
Woo!
Yeah!
Boom! I heard a quote one time. It was, perfection is the moment where preparation meets opportunity. And, you know, that's kind of the same thing. I think here's where you're trying to have a perfect week.
That's choking it right there.
You know, when you win, everything's perfect. I haven't lost a fish all week. I spent a lot of time on the lake looking around, so that's my preparation. And now I got the opportunity. So now it's really just a matter of what do I do with it.
The action continues deeper and deeper into it. The World Championship of Bass Fishing, the Bassmaster Classic 2013. $500,000 at the end of the line for one of these anglers, and it just gets more and more interesting. Meanwhile, back here at the BOK Center in Tulsa, getting closer to that time when we bring the guys back in and decide that championship. A year ago, that championship went to this man right here. Let's hear it for the 2012 Bassmaster Classic champion, Chris Lane. Yes, yes indeed. You talk about a guy, Mark Zona, the Classic champion represents for the entire sport, the entire bass fishing community. Can we get a better representative than this guy?
Absolutely, one of the best tournaments. And not only that, we knew how much that meant to you, Chris. You have been phenomenal all year long representing.
You know, it's been a true honor. And I tell you what, the letters, the emails from all of you, the fans, trust me, we read them, we get them. You guys are awesome. Tulsa, Grand Lake, Grove, Oklahoma, you guys have done a phenomenal job here, and today somebody's life will change when they win the Bassmaster Classic.
That's when you'll end your active reign. You'll always be a Classic champion, and people have been following your story this week with great interest because it has been some drama, some ups and downs, a zero on the first day, you bang back with 18 plus on the second day. What in the world is going on?
You know, I went back to game plans in my head, back to the 2012 Classic, and I think mentally it was I was so cold out there on that first tournament, not dealing with that. I think I've got out of that a little bit, and I never had a bite from the fish to kind of tell me how they wanted that Lucky Strike jerkbait. So, you know, day two goes out there, and it's not my 10th, 15th cast. I worked real slow. I got a bite. And then after that, three casts later, I catch a 4.5-pounder, and I said, it's on now, let's go. The fish, I blame 50% of that on them because they never gave me a bite to tell me how they wanted the jerkbait.
It's always their fault.
One of the things that we've been watching throughout this event, and it is how you caught these fish. Really, almost this entire tournament, we've heard suspended bass, that a lot of these guys that are catching these fish, suspended bass, some of the hardest bass in the world to catch.
Oh, absolutely. And you know, when you go out there and when you're throwing a jerk bait or a drop shot, whatever you're trying to fish with, you know, you want that bait to stay in front of the fish as long as you can. So when you're out there and you're trying to catch these fish, at times a school of bait fish will come by and they'll chase that, they'll chase the fish up there, the bait fish, and then they'll ambush them right then. So if you can catch them at that minor time period that you've got, you can catch a big sack pretty quick, like what happened yesterday. Now, when they're sitting out there and they're not wanting to bite, that's when, you know, these guys that are really catching the big bags are doing it.
When you're looking at these fish right here, suspended up off the bottom, is one of the hardest things in the world to catch these is just telling yourself, when you got that jerkbait out there, there's one looking at it. I know there's one looking at it.
Yes, and that's the thing, when you look at your Lowrance Electronics and you're looking down at it, and all of a sudden you're sitting there, and all of a sudden you've got just all these fish sitting there, and they're in 10 foot of water, and you get your bait down there, and they're not biting, and you ask yourself, why? I asked myself a lot of that on the first day, why?
Would you say that is probably the hardest way to catch fish?
It is truly the hardest way to catch fish for me, especially being from from down south, but it's some of the best, most fun ways to catch giant bags of bass, especially on Grand Lake, which is a phenomenal lake, and it's got the sevens and eights, and I'm telling you, when they hit a jerkbait, you better hang on.
He is still the reigning classic champ for a few minutes anyway. Let's give it up one more time for my man Chris Lane. We're gonna get a new champ crowned here in the BOK Center in just a little while, but meanwhile, we got some more fishing, important fishing yet to go. We'll have that for you in a minute.
Our coverage continues this 2013 Bassmaster Classic. This is the big day, the crucial final day of 3 days of competition. And what started out with a substantial lead for Cliff Pace now gotten a little bit tighter. Things bear watching very closely. Cliff Pace, though, our leader, a man who has perhaps been a little unheralded in the bass fishing world. He's got all the talents, and he's come so close so very many times.
Oh, oh, he come off.
Pace had a strong rookie season and qualified for the Bassmaster Classic his first year as an elite angler. South Carolina at Lake Hartwell, he was in third place to start the final day. He climbed up to second place. Was he able to close it out?
He's looking for 8 pounds and 6 ounces, and here we go. Get it, 13 pounds, 7 ounces. Alden Jones claims the 38.
But since that classic, Cliff Pace has been one of the most consistent anglers on the Bassmaster Elite Series, but that was then, and this is now. Cliff Pace really struggling today. We're gonna get on the water with him right now and find out exactly what has happened since the first 2 days of competition.
This is a rare opportunity to get inside the mind of one of the most talented anglers, certainly the most talented over the first couple of days here. Cliff Pace, Cliff, thanks for the minute you've got to spend with us. What is going on in your mind at this point in the proceedings?
I'm just trying to get some bites. I've had a real hard day.
Very unfortunate so far. And I hadn't really done anything wrong. I don't feel like I'm fishing the wrong way. It's just for some reason I just haven't had the opportunity today. But we got a couple of hours left still. And, you know, every day it's been one of those things where I fish a lot of places and all of a sudden I'll pull up somewhere and get two or three bites. And that's what I'm hoping happens. That's what I need to have happen. Catching a few right now would be a big momentum swing for me. And it's just a grind. It's been like this all week. The wind direction today is kind of taking some of my water from me. It's not very productive, and it was something I was really counting on. And so I'm just kind of scrambling around, fishing some things where I've had some bites back in practice and just trying to get something to happen.
Cliff, real quick, this week you've had one game plan, and that was to fish for quality instead of quantity. Has it got into your mind at all to abandon what has got you here so far and totally void it and go do something else?
Yeah, I've kind of committed to doing something else with the rest of my day. What I'm doing is just not working. So I'm not doing something else, really. I'm still fishing the same way. I'm just not spending my afternoon the way I have been.
Cliff, everybody who leads the Classic has to deal with it. A whole bunch more people following you on that final day. Have you been able to keep them at bay, and have you been able to keep them out of your mind?
Yeah, everything's been fine with the spectators. They've all done a great job. Hey guys, I appreciate it. I got an hour and a half to go. We got work to do.
All right, thank you so very much, Cliff Pace. Taking a little time for us there. That's a bonus.
It definitely is a bonus. And the best way to put where he's at right now in bass fishing, any bass fisherman that's out there when you're fishing, you have voices in your head. Am I doing what's right? Am I doing what's wrong? Imagine what is going through his mind right now, not having a limit the final day. The lead that he had was so enormous. We said it. Nobody's gonna topple this guy. The next three hours of competition will be some of the most amazing stuff we've ever seen in a classic.
Well, Cliff Pace has definitely got his hands full today. This angler, hats off to him, grew up in southern Mississippi. No deep water, not much in the way of cold water there over the course of the last 5 years. He's pretty much taught himself how to deal with places like Grand Lake of the Cherokees.
Exactly right, Tommy. We're going to jump on the water right now with Hank Cherry from North Carolina. And as bad as a day as we've seen so far with Cliff Pace, really the door is still open in a very big way for guys like Pace. You look at Brandon Polinick. This tournament is far from over.
Come on, baby. put it to bed, just like you're at home. Telling you, nobody's doing this. It's beautiful, look. Nobody's doing it. I'm telling you, that's the thing about bass fishermen. They outsmart ourselves all the time. You know how they say you miss the forest for the trees sometimes? Or the trees from the forest, whichever way it goes. Man, this is just basic, simple. Only thing that doesn't make any sense about this is there haven't been a bite on these things in practice. Not a bite. I think it's a drum. No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. Get up in the boat. Five.
Hank Cherry continues to move in a positive direction, now within 3 pounds, more or less, of our leader, Cliff Pace. He said things would be different today.
Exactly. We're going to jump out to Iaconelli right now, and you're seeing a total different day today. We saw on day number two, one of the reasons why, got a little bit more wind today. Cliff Pace, one of the only consistent anglers on day number two. That has been a total reversal today.
Different fishing every day. Today, I mean, I'm really kind of fishing by the seat of my pants. You know, it's the last day, I need a big bag, so I'm trying to just do what the fish are telling me. I've caught 4 fish on 3 different baits today. Just trying to be real fluid and fish the moment. I feel like this is my only chance to really win is to fish a lot of new stuff and to kind of let the fish tell me what to do. Here's a big one, here's a big one. Oh God, big one. Oh God, it's a big one. Stay on there. Stay on there. Oh God! He's barely hooked. Yeah! There's a 4-pounder. Look at that thing. Crankbait. DT6. DT6. In your face! In your face!
Mike Iaconelli with a solid fish catch right there and directly right in his face.
Absolutely. None of the distractions like he had yesterday from Michael Iaconelli. He's getting to do his job. He is grinding, moving slowly up that leaderboard behind Cliff Pace and this man, Brandon Polinick.
Exactly right, Tommy Sanders. And so far this tournament, Brandon Polinick has been really consistent. Days 1, 2, and 3. We've been watching him all day. And Tommy Sanders, I got some news. We're not the only ones.
There's my family. Yep. Yeah, they just like randomly come out of the woodwork. Coming out of the woodwork. You'd think it was like a colony of people living back in those woods. They've been following me all week. Every time, everywhere I go, they drive around the lake and find me. So we've got parents, aunts, uncles, friends, grandparents. I think that's only about half of them that are here, too, I think.
It's incredibly bizarre. They, like, stay motionless in a creepy way, and they have this strange distance between each other.
Can we get back to the tournament right
so
now?
Weird.
Because Brandon Polinick, right now, really starting to make a difference.
See that? Fish ate it right off that rock. Oh, stay down. Oh, that one ate it good. Good one. Woo! Yeah! That's choking it right there. That is choking it. That one ate it a little bit better. We got 5.
Now we got about 13, 14, 14 and a half or so. We got to start.
And nobody saw this one coming earlier this morning. Brandon Polinick is in the lead in the 2013 Bassmaster Classic.
Brandon Polinick started this day 7 pounds behind Cliff Pace. There's a couple of things at work here. Cliff Pace, so far on this day, and we're getting up into it, only has two fish. Brandon Polinick now with a limit and now 2 pounds ahead of Cliff Pace. This young man whose career's been spectacular, poised to make another stellar rise.
Woo! Yeah!
That's choking it right there. That is choking it.
Watching our coverage of the 43rd Bassmaster Classic. That's how we start the season in this year of 2013 with the World Championship, the biggest day in the sport of bass fishing, and this is the third day of 3 days of competitive action. 53 anglers qualified, 25 out there today. Our host city, Tulsa, Oklahoma, and this place, the Grand Lake of the Cherokees, has been a fabulous place. What a terrific body of water to test the best in the world on.
Been fantastic, you know, temps all the way down around zero with wind chill on day one of the tournament, and really spectators all over the lake. And I made this comment throughout this week of competition. Really, if you look at Grand Lake of the Cherokees, whether it's Tulsa or Grove, really, really one of the best hosts we've ever seen.
4,000 people showing up in single-digit wind chills to watch a takeoff at a fishing tournament. This is an extraordinary community up here in northeastern Oklahoma, and it has been more than impressive. With downtown Tulsa, the BOK Center's been the headquarters, the epicenter of the whole thing as far as the weigh-in goes. Maximum capacity crowds each and every day. What a place this has been. What a community to host the Bassmaster Classic. It's amazing. It's never come here before.
Time for our Bass Cam presented by Humminbird. Tommy, a little love from our Italian friends. Came here from overseas.
Man, it's
Michael Italy for you.
Yeah.
Number one.
Yeah, look at these crazy guys.
We got guys from Italy.
Yeah. Grand invite. Number one!
Come on.
Two fans from Italy, man. Really, really taking up some time with Mike Iaconelli. Very generous about that.
Italian fire drill.
Let's get back out on the water and Kevin Van Dam.
And really, Kevin Van Dam's demise during this event was on day number two. He said the bass never fired. He's been focusing on main lake pockets, little coves, and he said really throughout his practice time, he knocked their lights out. His worst day in practice was around 21 pounds. Kevin Van Dam knows he needs to catch between 25 to 30 pounds today. And really, that has not been the case. One good one early this morning. Kevin Van Dam really trying to make something happen.
Keeper. It's still that kind of deal ain't gonna do me any good. Right now it's that time of day. I got about 2 hours of fishing left. And it hasn't been going very well today, and I'm just, you know, yesterday I made a move to an area, you know, and where the water's a little dirtier in the back of a creek, and thought I could catch him shallow cranking, and it didn't work out. I'm really tempted to do it again, but I can't see how the result would be much different a day later. It's not warming or anything.
Kevin Van Dam knocked out about 20 pounds on day one, half of that on day number two. It looks like day three is going to be a little bit more like that.
Bad classic for Kevin Van Dam, expecting big things. But over here, this is the turnaround of the tournament right now. Look at that big group of spectator boats. They know what's going on. Going to get out on the water right now with Brandon Polinick, who is making big things happen.
Brandon Polinick, everyone's been talking about how cool, calm, and collect. How can you be that way on the final day of the Bassmaster Classic and you're in the thing?
As far as I'm concerned, Tommy, I'm still 7 pounds down. You know, so I still need to get a couple big bites. I'm just trying to focus on every cast that I make, trying to make that happen. But I'm going to tell you, I'll be honest, it has slowed down for me.
Brandon, has this been a tournament where you've had to adjust every single day as far as techniques go?
Yeah, it's actually more so than what I expected. You know, I caught them this morning good on a wiggle wart, and I threw it in practice, and I caught some fish. But I never felt like the conditions were right for it the last few days of the tournament. And then today I tied it on this morning and went to catching them, you know, and that's been a huge key for me because pretty much the majority of all my fish that I've got in the well right now came on that wiggle ward.
We know you got some family up on the back there cheering you on. You got a lot of people following you around. Is that a help or is that a stress maker for you?
You know, I don't really notice it a whole lot. It's really cool to be able to have my family up on the bank following, watching along. You know, so I think that helps out a little bit. They sure do get loud when I hook into one.
All right, you got 1 hour left to go. Brandon, best of luck to you.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Polinick's done an amazing thing today, erased a 7-pound deficit. Thing to remember is, though, he's got a limit. Cliff Pace only has two fish at this point.
Two fish, and really, we thought Cliff Pace was going to put this thing away very early. Brandon Polinick, a couple good bites, and the biggest comeback we've ever seen.
That might be a drum. Well, no, that's a largemouth. It's a good one. It's a good one. Oh, she barely hooked. Oh, it's not that as big as I thought. There we go.
Brandon Polinick grinding on. He certainly has been the success story of this final day of the Bassmaster Classic. Again, he started with a 7-pound deficit to our leader at the time to start the third day, Cliff Pace. And Cliff Pace, a different story himself, a young man who's worked very hard out here, has come so close so many times, including a second place in the Bassmaster Classic, and he comes into this day with a big lead, but heavy is the burden that the leader bears. A lot of people say they don't want the lead going into the final day because of all the things that go on inside your brain.
Well, if you've ever fished in your entire life, all you do is have voices. Am I in the right area? Am I throwing the right bait? And with the day that Cliff Pace has had, only having two bass, you're in the final couple of hours of the Bassmaster Classic. You know, more than likely, you have lost the lead that you owned earlier today. And really, for the first time during this entire event, Cliff Pace said, he goes, I've got a game plan. I am not fishing for numbers. I am fishing for quality only. Well, right now, Cliff Pace has to put something in the live well. The next hour and a half, probably the most critical in Cliff Pace's entire career.
Come on, baby doll. Come on, fish. I know the wind ain't the direction you want. Oh, yes. All right. Come on, one more.
Tell Cliff Pace now is in survival mode, fishing an area right there he has not been to all week long. Not a big bass, but a huge one for Cliff Pace.
Yeah, Cliff Pace was sitting on two fish, nowhere near a limit. That was his third fish right there. The thing to keep in mind is his weight until he has five, all of it, every ounce, goes to the bottom line, unlike those guys who have already notched a limit. Back over to Michael Iaconelli. Cliff Pace's catch right there suddenly puts Iaconelli from being close to 5 pounds back.
There's one. Big one, too. Oh God, he's not hooked good. Two pounder. A limit fish anyway. There's a lot of time left. It feels good to have five, you know. I can tell you with the weight I have right now, I don't have any chance of winning. But, you know, I've got two good ones. I've got two okay ones, and I've got one little one. You know, with almost four hours left, just gotta keep fishing. You know, one or two of them magnum bites, and it's just, the day's totally different.
We have seen a lot in the last couple of minutes. Michael Iaconelli sitting third place, 4.5 pounds behind our leader, Brandon Polinick, just 0.5 pound behind the man who's back on top, Cliff Pace.
And really what Pace did not want in this final day of competition was, whether it's Iaconelli, Cherry, Brandon Polinick, to be within one solid bite of winning this tournament, and that is exactly where we're sitting right now.
Brandon Polinick, the angler from Idaho, fishes on the Bassmaster Elite Series. He is 1/2 pound behind our leader, Cliff Pace, on this, the final day of the World Championship of Bass Fishing, the Bassmaster Classic. Grand Lake of the Cherokees in northeast Oklahoma, just up the turnpike from Tulsa. What a crowd is watching him here as he has erased a monumental deficit, 7 pounds, to get where he is right now, and he is right in the thick of it.
Oh. Maybe it is. Coming back.
Go, Brendan!
Oh!
And that hurts. I have no idea what happened. It just came off. I absolutely have no idea what happened on that one. Oh, that's not good right there. That is not good.
Oh!
You cannot win the classic pulling stunts like that. Man, I don't know what happened on that one. I so badly wish I had a little birdie watching Cliff Pace right now, and Ike and the rest of the guys that are close to know what's going on, because, man, that hurts. Hurts. Haven't lost a fish all week long.
Well, we couldn't positively identify the size of that fish, but you could tell by the size of the reaction that was significant. Could have made a big difference in the outcome for Brandon Polinick there, being just 1/2 pound separating him and our leader, Cliff Pace. Hank Cherry, another guy who's been right there with him all day long. He's fallen behind just a little bit, and from 3 pounds behind the leader, Cliff Pace, here's Hank Cherry.
We're going to go under the water right now and take a look at what Hank Cherry did earlier today. And it's really one of the only times throughout this tournament we saw this technique transpire. You see, Hank Cherry has lived with a mega bass jerkbait the entire week. And it's really, Tommy, it's how he fished this bait all week long. You take a look at this. You know, you saw him catch a giant off of a dock this morning. And all these docks have cables and obstructions that you have to work around. But if you really watch Cherry and Mike Iaconelli, it's how they work the bait. And there's not a term to describe it. A lot of people think of a jerkbait as you're cracking it and get it real aggressive. What Hank Cherry and Iaconelli were really doing with their jerkbait all week long, it's almost like they were just kind of feathering it, just barely popping that slack for all these sluggish fish. And those fish would just kind of lethargically come up and dunk, and when they would bite that bait. And that was one of the problems. A lot of those fish didn't really eat that bait very well throughout the week. In fact, you look earlier today, that was a 4 to 5 pound bite. And that really haunted a lot of our anglers all week long.
Hank Cherry, of course, lost fish, a big part of the Hank Cherry story. Again, these guys are getting 7-8 bites a day. We see it all compressed together, but these are significant losses. They affect the outcome of this tournament.
They absolutely have. And somehow, you know, with the day that Cliff Pace has had out on the water, Hank Cherry is absolutely still in this. You know, he gets one giant bite, Hank Cherry can put this thing away.
That might be him. That might be him. Oh God, stay down. Oh God, stay down, stay down. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God, stay down. Please God, stay down. Stay down. Watch out. Stay down. Stay down. Ain't ready yet. Ain't ready yet. Ain't ready yet. Come on. No, sir. No, sir. No, sir. Get both rocks. Get both rocks. Come here. God!
How do you pick up the pieces from something like that? Hank Cherry, and a fish right there that came off, could have, who knows, could have put him back in the lead, tied for the lead. Just no telling at this point. You just got to fish on and hope for something good to happen in the waning moments of this Bassmaster Classic final day of fishing. We got to check in with the man who is now, well, he's our leader, but not by much, a half pound ahead of Brandon Polinick. That's Cliff Pace.
And really, what Cliff Pace has done all day long, absolutely, you have to give it to him. His biggest trait is how calm he is. Still, just looking for fish number four.
Come on, darling. I know you can do it. Just please, come here. Come here. Yes. 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 One more. Yes!
Still not a limit, but with four fish, Cliff Pace's chances to hang on and wire-to-wire victory this Classic look a lot better.
Really, and we talk about it on the Bassmaster Elite Series, if you're going to win events, big events like this, you stick to your strength, and that is exactly what Cliff Pace did all week long.
Well, the anglers will soon load up and head back down to Tulsa, Oklahoma, right downtown the BOK Center. The place is full. It is rocking. We are going to bring the thunder. We are going to bring the pageantry of the final weigh-in of the Bassmaster Classic when we come back.
The Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa, is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops, Humminbird, Mercury, and by Minn Kota.
We are about to come to the dramatic conclusion of the Bassmaster Classic 2013 presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tulsa, taking you right inside the BOK Center in downtown Tulsa. Once again, we've got a capacity crowd primed and ready to crown a world champion. First, we crown our Carhartt Big Bass of the tournament, Mark Pierce. His big one weighed 7 pounds and 4 ounces. Also time to recognize our Berkeley Big Bag of the tournament. That would be Cliff Pace, day number two of the competition, 21 pounds and 12 ounces, including those two big oversized bass, which really made the difference. Well, now the time has come. It's time to crown our world champion. Let's get ready and start the weigh-in.
Ladies and gentlemen, now it's time to meet your 2013 Bassmaster Classic Super Six!
I know I need to come from behind.
It's what we call the Tulsa Fall right there.
This lake has the potential to do it.
Day one, Bassmaster Classic, first 5 minutes.
There are 25-pound sacks weighed in here often.
Yeah!
That's choking it right there.
19 pounds, 10 ounces.
Perfection is the moment where preparation meets opportunity. I've got 8 hours to make it happen.
It's the final day of the Bassmaster Classic. I'm here, I'm gonna go out and do what I can do.
Cliff Pace sets a pace.
You know, there is no defense in the sport. For us, it's gonna be all just about what we can do and we can control.
Yeah!
Cliff has a bad day and I have a great day, we make magic happen.
The 2013 Bassmaster Classic, presented by Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa.
Well, this is it. There is nothing like it in the world of sports. The final day of the World Championship of Fishing, the Bassmaster Classic, 2013 edition, Grand Lake of the Cherokees. And here in Tulsa, Oklahoma, they are excited about it. Everyone is excited about it because The winner, the one who takes home that trophy, will get an immediate kick in the terms of $500,000. His name in the history books, written big time, and of course, a life change. Your life gets a lot easier if you win the Bassmaster Classic. I'm Tommy Sanders, along with Mark Zona. So many stories over the 3 days of fishing. As we go into this final day, there is one story about one angler who has a substantial lead.
Really, that's the only story right now. If you look at our leader, Cliff Pace, 7-pound lead, and this angler has never won a Bassmaster Elite Series event before, more or less a Bassmaster Classic. Really, if you're to equate a 7-pound lead, that's like having a 3-touchdown lead going into the fourth quarter. We're looking for two things on this final day. Either he's going to blow this thing away in the first 2 hours, or an epic collapse, one of the two right now.
It's hard to pick what's gonna happen, but we do know this. This final day is unlike any other these guys ever faced. So many different things you have to deal with.
Well, the one thing he's gonna deal with today, number one, Grand Lake has got him. Grand Lake loaded with big bass, and we've seen huge stringers.
Boy, everything's getting ratcheted up inside the BOK Center here. Just about time to meet the Super Six sitting in the hot seat. The biggest weight total among our anglers who've weighed in so far, Mike McClellan. He won't leave it until he's unseated. First up is Kevin Van Dam, the four-time Classic champion, fishing in his 23rd Classic. With a weight of 41.11, Kevin Van Dam will not unseat McClellan. Jason Christie, who generated more talk before this event than Jason Christie, the Oklahoma native, but he's got a total of 43.5. He can't do it. And now, Hank Cherry of North Carolina.
Unfortunately, that's not the only one that I lost. I had another one close to the boat. It was probably 5 pounds that come off. So they're probably gonna cost me. But you know, there's worse things that I could be doing right now. I mean, I'm at the Bassmaster Classic. All these great people. That's all I can say about it.
Hank Cherry with 49 pounds takes over the hot seat, and now we see Michael Iaconelli, co-leader. Day number one fell back a little on day number two. See how day number three went. He's not going to be able to do it either. Hank Cherry stays in the hot seat. And now Brandon Polinick, we've watched him all day long. He has been the man of the hour. Can he win the tournament?
Looking for 12 pounds of 13 ounces. I can feel his heart beating all the way over here. 15 pounds, 4 ounces. Brandon Polinick grabs the lead with one angler left to go.
When we met you, you spent your first season on the Bassmaster Elite Series. And where did you sleep?
Back of my truck.
You hold this baby over your head, I don't think you're staying in the back of your truck anymore.
Brandon Polinick with 51.8, and now the moment of truth. To the scales, Cliff Pace.
Brandon, come on over here. I want you guys to get side by side. One of you guys is going to win this. He needs 8 pounds, 5 ounces. One short of a limit. 11 pounds, 8 ounces. Cliff Pace has done it.
There he is, Cliff Pace. He has been in control of this tournament since day number one. Co-leader after a single day of fishing, extends his lead to 7 pounds after day two, and somehow manages to find a way to hold on.
The 2013 Bassmaster Classic champion, Cliff Pace, has done it.
Hey, let's give it up for our 2013 Bassmaster Classic champion. Cliff Pace not only wins it, takes it wire to wire. Co-leader on day one, outright leader day two, brought it on home. Cliff, how long have you been working and waiting for this day?
Well, I'm 32 years old, so I guess about 31 and a half years.
You made the comment right before you won. You said that was the hardest day of fishing in your entire life. Kind of just walk us through that day.
Well, you know, all through this event, I've been fishing for key bites. The first 2 days it worked out, I got a couple of those bites. But in the course of a day, I'm only getting 6 or 7 bites. And you have to fish very, very slow to get those 6 or 7 bites. So I knew my best chance. If I got in a hurry, I knew it was not going to happen. I haven't caught any fish this week fishing fast. So I just went to a creek that I had a lot of confidence in. I had some bites fishing around. And I just bared down, made myself fish really slow. You know, when you throw that football head jig out there and count every rock it touches on the way back to the boat, very next cast, I caught another. And that was the last two bites I got for the day. Never caught any more fish, but it was enough.
Cliff Pace, you're now the representative for the sport of bass fishing. You are the ambassador. Let's hear it for our 2013 Bassmaster Classic champion, Cliff Pace.